Last 1 minute to start the meeting. Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Regret for the issue with the connectivity. Warm welcome to the 25th annual general meeting of the company and the first electronic annual general meeting held pursuant to the regulations prescribed by Ministry of Corporate Affairs as well as Securities Exchange Board of India. I am Om Prakash here, your company secretary and compliance officer. Joining from the corporate office of the company, I have with me Mr. M. R. Jaishankar, Chairman and Managing Director. Mr. Atulian, our CFO. So joining remotely from their respective locations are the executive directors. I'll call them one by one in the alphabetical order. Mr. Amar Mysore, executive director.
Morning. Logging in from the corporate office.
Ms. Nirupa Shankar, Executive Director.
Good morning, everyone.
Ms. Pavitra Shankar, Executive Director. Ms. Roshan Mathew, Executive Director.
All the directors are requested to unmute first, then say good morning. Thank you.
Now I'll go ahead with the independent directors. Mr. Arun Brandon, independent director and chairperson of the Nomination and Remuneration Committee.
Morning.
Mr. Biju Kurian, independent director.
Good morning to everybody.
Ms. Lakshmi Venkatachalam, independent director.
She is present, sir.
Yeah. Mr. Pradeep Kumar Pancha, independent director and chairperson of the audit committee. Dr. Venkatesh Panchavagishan, independent director and chairman of the stakeholders relationship committee.
Good morning, everyone. I'm calling in from the residence.
Yeah. Thank you, directors. The representatives of the statutory auditors, secretarial auditor, internal auditors and cost auditors and senior management officials are present at this meeting from their respective locations. Electronic inspection of statutory registers and the statutory auditor certificate on the ESOP scheme 2011 and 2017 are available for inspection during the course of this meeting. The requisite quorum for the meeting is present. There are no proxy allowed for this meeting. Now I'll hand it over to the Chairman and Managing Director, Mr. M.R. Jaishankar, to conduct the further proceedings. Thank you.
Good morning to all. I welcome you to all to the 25th annual general meeting of the company and the first electronic AGM. We would have liked to meet you in person, but due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the same is presently not possible. Hope you and your family members are healthy and staying safe. The annual report, including the notice of the meeting and the unqualified statutory auditor's report on the financial statements, have been emailed to you, to all the shareholders, and I suggest that the same be taken as read. Now I'll proceed to read with my annual speech. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning again. It's my pleasure to welcome you all again to the 25th AGM of your company. This AGM is very different, but as we are unable to meet you in person. Therefore, we decided, the thing is being done electronically, offline, with the help of K FinTech, who have a robust software and have tried their best to take care of all the eventualities. And sorry about the initial glitches. The Wuhan virus originated from China during December of last year has created unprecedented havoc to the world, which none of us have witnessed in our lifetime. In my opinion, life has turned upside down, a 180 degree change. People have become helpless, more philosophical. Many businesses have been run to the ground. India is staring at the worst recession since independence. Other countries are experiencing the worst times since Second World War and Great Depression of 1929. Hapless governments across the world are taking various measures to control the virus. It is unimaginable that an invisible organism has brought the world to its knees, with 33 million plus people affected and a million people dead, and increasing by the day, with no end in sight till an effective vaccine is invented. I feel even after the vaccine is released, after successful clinical trials, we do not know how many years it will take to vaccinate the 7,800 million population of this world. No one knows so far whether the vaccine will give lifelong immunity or should it be injected every year like flu vaccine. With all these uncertainties, life has to go on. We need to do what we have to do and leave the rest to Providence, our destiny, and our karma. In times like this, countries' leaders are in an unenviable position. Tough situations call for tough decisions. Damned if you take and damned if you don't take the tough decisions. Our PM Modi, known for his decisive leadership, bit the bullet by locking down the entire country for 40 full days, the only time since our independence in 1947. It did create panic and resulted in untold misery to millions of migrant labor across the country. It did help save lives and spread of the Wuhan virus initially. But once lockdown was lifted and people movement started, including gradual return of the migrant labor, the COVID positive cases started increasing. India has reached the dubious distinction of having the second highest number of cases, next only to the United States. Now livelihoods have taken precedence over lives, as can be seen with economy opening up more and more month after month, although the number of cases are going up. In hindsight, one wonders whether the lockdown was announced too early by the government. During this crisis time, many developed countries have come up with attractive stimulus packages for their citizens and businesses. In spite of India being a developing country, our government came up with a very ambitious rupees 20 lakh crores stimulus package. While it did raise the expectation of the business and industry community, unfortunately, too much fine print did not allow the benefit to reach different sectors as intended. Personally, I feel doles should be restricted only to the economically weaker sections in the society. For businesses, what is required is to unshackle them from the multitude of regulations and come up with simple, transparent rules. As a SOP, government should reduce taxes like GST, stamp duty, and few others, at least for a year or so, to give boost for the economy to recover. Otherwise, to get back to positive GDP growth over 2019 or earlier year figures, it will take very long time. Oxygen should be administered timely and when needed. In this not so happy external environment, with all its challenges, you'll be happy to know your company has performed fairly well during the financial year ending 31st March 2020. While viewing the accounts, you have to keep in mind the impact of our accounts due to the changes in Indian Accounting Standard 115. To give you a few important performance statistics, the consolidated revenue dropped to 2,682 crores for the financial year ending 31st March 2020, from rupees 3,027 crores in financial year 2019, a reduction of 11%. So also, EBITDA has dropped to 713 crores from 844 crores, which is 16%. Whereas the profit after tax dropped sharply to 114 crores from 282 crores in view of higher depreciation and interest cost. The good news is sales have gone up to 4.3 million square feet in financial year 2020. So also, sales value has gone up from 1,644 crores to rupees 2,377 crores. New lease area of 2.45 million square feet was concluded during the year under review versus 1.2 million square feet of office leases in the previous year. So also, lease rental revenue has gone up to rupees 373 crores from rupees 320 crores. In addition, hospitality revenue has gone up to rupees 334 crores from rupees 309 crores, which is a 8% jump. Trying to achieve this, our debt equity ratio has gone up from 1.05:1 to 1.17:1, which is fairly healthy and acceptable. I am happy to mention that in spite of substantial lockdown during quarter one of financial year 2021, we were able to do 0.42 million square feet of new residential sales, and we should reach nearly a million square feet of new sales in Q2. You will also be happy to know that the office rental collections are at 99% in spite of the pandemic period. But unfortunately, hotel and retail segments have taken a big hit. While retail business in malls is showing signs of improvement week after week, hotel occupancy levels is likely to, improve, it is likely to take much longer time of 12 to 18 months. Coming to dividend announcement, you are aware that for the year ended 31st March 2020, your company has already paid an interim dividend of 10% during March 2020 itself. Now the same is being proposed for confirmation as final dividend, considering the very difficult external business environment we are going through and the reduction of profit. Please remember the 10% dividend is on the increased capital after bonus issue at the ratio of 1:2 shares last year as approved in the AGM. To give some more additional information on the company performance, during the last financial year, we have completed development of about 5.82 million square feet. Currently, an area of 21.37 million square feet is under construction, and we are gearing up to launch an area of 4.3 million square feet, comprised of 2.5 million square feet in residential business and 1.8 million square feet of leasing business. in the current year. Our two new integrated projects, Brigade Cornerstone Utopia in Whitefield and Brigade El Dorado Affordable Homes in Aerospace Park near Bangalore International Airport, have received very good response. Our marquee office buildings under construction, Brigade Tech Gardens and in Bangalore and World Trade Center in Chennai, have also received good response to leasing by corporates. We have leased large areas in World Trade Center Chennai to Amazon, Caterpillar, and McKinsey. In Bangalore, we have leased to Mercedes, Fidelity, First Source, and Manhattan, and few others. Coming to awards and recognitions, our practice of coming up with a trendsetter and landmark projects have earned us various awards and accolades in the past, and this year was no exception. To mention only a few, Brigade Cornerstone Utopia won the Integrated Township Project of the Year Award at the 11th Realty Plus Awards 2019. Brigade International Financial Center, BIFC, Gujarat, our flagship project in the GIFT City, Ahmedabad, received the Commercial Project of the Year Award in Realty Plus Awards 2019. Brigade Opus won the Best Commercial Complex Award at the CARE Awards 2019. Brigade Mountain View won the award for Best Residential Dwellings Above 50 Units in Mysore at the CARE Awards 2019. Brigade Group has been awarded India's Top Builders 2020 and the Brigade Group has been awarded the India's Top Builders 2020 at the Construction World Architects and Builders Awards. Yours truly received the Lifetime Achievement Award at the 11th Realty Plus Awards 2019 for South India. Brigade Enterprises Limited has been recognized as one of the top 100 best companies to work for 2020 by the Great Place to Work Institute and Economic Times. Brigade Enterprises has been ranked 43 in the coveted top 50 category across companies. Your company has the distinction of being India's top 100 best companies to work for 10 years in a row now. So also, Brigade Hospitality Services Limited has been ranked third amongst India's great mid-sized workplaces in 2020 by the Great Places to Work Institute. More importantly, Brigade Group was ranked one amongst India's 75 best places to work for women. This is very important for us. What next is the question each one will be asking for themselves. I believe life has to go on in this new normal situation, but only after complying with safety norms advised by the health authorities. Wearing masks, maintaining physical distance, increasing sanitation standards, and not being in overcrowded places. Otherwise, the negative impact on livelihoods can take catastrophic proportions. The concept of work from home has helped businesses, particularly in the services sector, to survive and to keep up their commitments. We humans are social animals, and most of us are longing to get back to our normal routine of returning to our workplaces and interacting with our colleagues and other people. Till normalcy returns, we all must exercise patience and perseverance in whatever we are supposed to do. At Brigade, we believe that our core values have helped the organizations in both good and difficult times to have come this far since our inception. We will continue to strive to live by our core values. More than anything, we also need to seek God's mercy for the normalcy to return soon. Your company is quite resilient during this most challenging times, and we have managed to keep our heads above the water unlike many small and medium-sized businesses. Our approach is to survive, stabilize, and then grow in business. Before I close, I would like to thank you, shareholders, on behalf of all the directors for the confidence reposed in the company. I would also like to place on record my sincere thanks to the staff of Brigade Group for their good work and contribution to the growth of the company. I would like to record my thanks to all other stakeholders like bankers, auditors, architects, consultants, contractors, landowners, vendors for their cooperation and support, and most importantly, to our valued customers without whom no business can survive. Lastly, my thanks to all other directors on board for their contribution and participation during the year, which has helped me discharge my responsibilities. Thank you all for your patient hearing. Jai Hind. Now, I request the company secretary to brief on the proceedings. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The annual report of the company for the year 2019-20 has been sent by electronic means to all the shareholders in accordance with the applicable guidelines issued by the regulatory authorities. The company has provided to its members the facility for e-voting to vote on the proposed resolutions from 26 September 2020, 9 a.m. till 28 September 2020, 5 p.m. Members who are not voted through remote e-voting can vote through the voting option made available by K-Fintech appearing at the left-hand bottom of the screen once the same is enabled on the instructions of the chairman. The company has appointed Mr. K. Rajshekar, practicing company secretary, as scrutinizer to scrutinize the e-voting process. The results of the meeting along with the scrutinizer's report will be put up on the website of the company once the same is intimated to the stock exchanges. The resolutions will not be proposed and seconded. Combined results of the remote e-voting and the e-voting during the meeting will be considered for approval of the resolutions. Now, a few instructions relating to shareholders registered for speaking at this meeting. All the registered speakers have been kept on mute. Speakers will be unmuted once their name is called out by the moderator. Speed and working of the audio-video mode for joining the meeting by the members depends on their internet capacity. If there is any technical glitch at the speaker shareholder's end, we will proceed to the next shareholder and we'll get back to you again after the technical glitch is sorted out. If any unanswered questions are there, then the same will be emailed to you. I would now request the chairman to move the resolutions.
With the permission of the members, I now move the resolutions by calling the brief description of the resolutions proposed to be passed. Resolution number one. Adoption of audited accounts for the year ended 31st March 2020 and the reports of the board, auditors thereon, and the audited consolidated accounts of the company and the reports of the auditors thereon for the year ended 31st March 2020. Resolution number 2. Interim dividend of rupee 1 per share paid during 2019-20 confirmed as final dividend for the financial year 2019-20. Resolution number 3. Appointment of Mr. Amar Mysore as a director liable to retire by rotation. And re-elect. Yeah. And reappointment, of course. Resolution number 4. Appointment of Ms. Nirupa Shankar as a director liable to retire by rotation. Resolution number 5. Reappointment of Mr. Biju Kurian as independent director for a second term of 5 years. Resolution number 6, appointment of Mr. Roshan Matthew as a whole-time director for a period of 5 years. Resolution number 7, ratification of remuneration payable to Messrs. Murthy & Company, LLP, cost accountants for the financial year 2019-20. Resolution number 8, remuneration to executive promoter directors in excess of the threshold limits under SEBI listing obligations and disclosure requirements regulations 2015. Resolution number 9, raise funds through issue of securities, convertible debentures and or equity shares, convertible warrants, etc. by way of qualified institution placement, QIP, rights issue, etc. up to ₹500 crores. The e-voting window shall now be activated for members to vote during the AGM. Members are requested to vote by clicking on the vote button visible on the left-hand bottom of your screen. Company secretary is authorized to declare the consolidated voting results. Now, I shall be glad to answer questions concerning the director's report and the audited financial statements. The moderator shall call the name of the speaker and then you can speak. I request the speakers not to repeat the questions and confine the speech to matters relating to the annual report and also restrict the speech to a maximum of 3 minutes. Answers to all the questions will be provided after all speakers have completed asking their questions. So now the moderator can go ahead and, you know, give opportunity for the shareholders to ask the questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman sir. This is your moderator, Praveen Chaturvedi. May I request the first speaker, Mr. Bharat Raj, to unmute himself, switch on his camera and speak. Thank you, Mr. Bharat Raj. Kindly.
Very good morning. Very good morning, Mr. Chairman. Audible?
Yes, sir, you are a bit louder.
Chairman, please excuse me. Due to the technical reason, I cannot be part of video. Please accept my audio, sir. First of all, Chairman, happy to see you. Entire board of directors, healthy, safe, fine, and happy. I am also healthy, safe, and fine. First of all, congratulations for the 25th meeting. Celebrate 25 years. 25 years, it is passed on like a 1 year, sir. I've seen the how you made our Brigade company a masterpiece icon in India. The way you build the buildings and gateway community buildings, I'm very proud of you, Mr. Chairman. Under your leadership, my company is growing, and thanks for dividends, sir. And thanks for your last year bonus. I'm Bharat Raj, sir. Last year I came to Hyderabad, I met you personally. I wish the pandemic has we don't get the opportunity to meet you, sir. But at least next AGM will celebrate the Silver Jubilee, sir. There is no issues regarding this annual report or anything, sir. We are very happy with your leadership, sir. I thank Mr. Amar Mysore and entire board of directors for the support. And be safe, sir. Be healthy. Fine, sir. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your kind words.
Our next speaker is Bharati Shraf from North 24 Partners. Bharati ji, kindly unmute yourself, switch on your camera and speak. Thank you. Bharati ji, sorry sir, we are not getting any input. So we are moving to our next speaker.
No, I would like to say Mr. Bharati Saraf has also sent written questions. So we can answer. I will read the question and also the answer, if that is fine with the moderator.
Yes, sir. At the last, you can use this, sir. Thank you, sir. Our next speaker is Mr. Ramesh Shankar Gola. Mr. Ramesh Shankar, kindly unmute yourself, switch on your camera and speak. Mr. Ramesh Shankar. Sir, we are not getting any input from Mr. Ramesh Shankar. So with this, we have completed calling out the name of the speakers. We are handing over back to you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. So I think Mr. Bharati Saraf has asked many questions. I think probably that that should take care of everyone's questions in my opinion. So I will read out and we'll try our best to give the answers to his questions. I will read now. Sir, I would like to thank and congratulate the board members and the CFO and all key managerial persons for their all-round achievements during the year, in spite of the business difficulties faced due to COVID-19 pandemic, and paid interim dividend of muted. Total of ₹1 per equity share on ₹10 face value of the share for the financial year ended 31st March 2020. So what is the question number one? Sir, what are COVID-19 impact and effect on company income? I think that has been answered in my speech. We did mention about the four business verticals, which is real estate, office, retail, and hospitality. I did mention in office, where collections are at 99%, and we have done almost 100% more than the previous year of leasing of new spaces. I did mention about our performance even the post-COVID in Q1 and Q2, that is fairly clear. And mall business and hospitality also, I did mention, like mall and hospitality businesses are affected. Currently, the walk-ins in malls are somewhere in the range of 35 to 40%, and business is slightly better than the percentage of walk-ins. And the hospitality business, around 15% occupancy average, which may help, which may improve in the next anywhere between 6 to 12 months, if not more. Question number two, what steps are taken by management to minimize impact and effect on business and activities of the company all across businesses? Our answer, we have reduced the fixed cost in all verticals compared to Q4 of previous year, financial year, that is 2019 and FY20. The fixed cost is reduced to the extent of 54 to 55% overall. Question number three, what steps are taken for cost cutting in COVID-19 pandemic uncertainty situation in companies? I think we have already answered about reducing fixed costs and also working hard to improve the business scenario, and which is showing results since in Q2, the business is almost the same as the Q2 of the previous financial year, which we consider is a happy situation. Next question. Sir, board of directors could think about cut in their remunerations, director sitting fees, commissions and perquisites, etc., by 30% in this COVID-19 pandemic period, when business is suffering in a very tough time to survive. Our answer, thank you for the suggestion. You will be happy to know the managing director has taken 100% salary cut from April to September 2020. Other executive directors and whole-time directors have taken 50% salary cut for the same period. Similarly, a lot of key managerial personnel and senior personnel have taken cuts at various levels, ranging from 20 to 50% for the period up to 30th September. Going forward, it is under review, and appropriate actions will be taken. And even the independent directors have taken a cut of the commission to the extent of 25%. And the company is quite conscious of the fact to conserve our resources. Thank you. Next question. How many employees we have sacked, hired, and salary cut in percentage, if any? I did mention to you that the salary cut ranges from 10% to 50% across different categories with a view to reduce the overall burden. And in this during this period, people whose performance was under question or maybe nearing retirement or retired and continuing in the company, have reached the retirement age and continuing the company, have been asked to exit. In many cases, it has happened voluntarily also. Whereas in the case of hospitality, there is a sharp reduction in the number of staff employed in the hotels. With the result, the break-even point has come down by almost 60 to 65% compared to the previous figures, which has helped some of the hotels to already meet operational expenditure. Next question. Sir, what are future capex plans of management to increase growth and income of the company? Answer, we have around ₹1,200 to ₹1,500 crores of capex planned for the next 2 to 3 years, and this may even go up depending on the market conditions. Next question. Sir, please provide the details of parties in other current and non-current liabilities. Please let me know the details of our contingent liabilities and if the company secretary can arrange a video call with your legal head to learn the perspective in detail. And sir, we request you to see page number 245. Sir, total female employees, next question. Sir, total female employees numbers present is 165, is only out of the total employees of 770 as on 31st March 2020. It is very less, and kindly let me know the view of management to empower more females to become self-dependent in the present socio-economic scenario. Our answer, as I mentioned in my speech, you'll be happy to know, Brigade Group has been considered as amongst the best companies for women to work across the country as per Great Place to Work and Economic Times Institute. Great Place to Work Institute and Economic Times. The company is open to employ women or anybody else purely on merits and based on the kind of job requirement, since we are also in construction sector, which is which has got its own nuances. So, but you will also be happy to know we are probably the only developer in the country to have few projects, construction projects, fully manned, or I should say fully womaned by female employees. It is taken care by only women employees. Next question. Sir, I am surprised that you have one disabled employee in your total permanent staff of 770. Nowadays, a person with disabilities are topping IAS exam and at the same time, they're winning medals in Paralympic Games for India and many others. Continue to do very good job or work for the country. Kindly let me know your view on giving an opportunity to them in the form of jobs or any other means. It's a good observation and suggestion. We will look at it in a holistic manner, but at the same time, as I said, we have to look at this on a merit-based way, and not the company should not be treated as an employment provider for anybody and everybody, even if there is no requirement. So, but we take cognizance of your suggestion, and our HR team will keep that in mind and try to make extra effort to, I would say for gender equality and, giving opportunities to disabled, physically challenged. I wouldn't want to use the word disabled, physically challenged people. Next question. Sir, on page number 112, you reported that there are many tax disputed cases that are pending from year 2008 to 2009. In this regard, kindly tell me why you are not interested in settling these cases with state government or with central government under Vivad Se Vishwas and Sabka Vishwas scheme launched by the central government. We did not say we are our answer. We did not say we are not interested in settling these cases. Each and every case that is there would be viewed on merit, its own merit, and the senior personnel and the board will take appropriate decisions within the deadline of time provided under these schemes. So we are confident of taking merit-based decisions in the best interest of your company. Next question. Sir, kindly let me know the number of shareholders attended today video or audio conference meeting. I think the moderator will intimate you later. And next question, kindly tell me what was the expenses amount of last year physically held AGM at venue, including printing and postage of notice and annual reports, and on traveling of directors for AGM and other related expenses, and what are the expenses estimated of this year meeting through VC and OAVM 52. So it is about rupees 15 lakhs. That's our answer. Lastly, I'll read what the gentleman has written. I wish the company and the board of directors and all employees of the company and related persons stay safe and healthy and a great success and prosperity in the coming future. In case of any network failure or other unavoidable circumstances, if I cannot be present for the video conferencing on the AGM day, please consider this as my document to be placed in front of the chairman for the record and reply. This has been taken note of, and I have personally read each and every question of yours, Mr. Saraf, and I have answered. Trust you are more than happy. Thank you very much. Yeah. Lastly, coming to the almost the end of the proceedings, the members who have not yet voted may now cast their vote. The e-voting will end on casting of the last vote or 15 minutes from the end of this meeting, whichever is earlier. I now declare the meeting as closed. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you very much. Over to the moderator.
Thank you, sir. With these proceedings, we have completed the proceedings and we are going to apply the last 15-minute Insta poll. All the directors can log off. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, moderator. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.